mention the grade of the concrete. After that grade of the concrete, these are the minimum essential required or minimum data required for the mixed design. So what do you mean by stipulations for the proportioning? First one, grade designation is M40. Okay, let us, I will take it as an M40 grade designation. Mean nothing but our compressive strength, target compressive strength should be 40 newton per mm square after 28 days. So minimum compressive strength of the concrete should be 40 newton per mm square after 28 days. Next, type of the cement, OPC 43 grade. Type of the cement is OPC 43 grade and confining the IS code of IS 8112. This is only reference for cement. IS 456 for site conditions, which is used in the design. IS 10262 mixed design. IS 8112 for size of aggregate. Next, minimum cement content is nothing but 20 kg per meter cube. Maximum nominal size of the aggregate is 20 mm. And the maximum water to cement ratio is W by C is equals to 0.45. So here the workability, nothing but slump value is taken as a 100. These are all the given data or given conditions. And the exposure site condition should be sewer. Method of the concrete placing is pumping. And degree of supervision is good. And type of the aggregate is nothing but a crushed angular aggregates. And maximum cement content, 450 kg per meter cube. Chemical admixture type is superplasticizer. Next, test data for materials. These are the given data, right? For here, they have given only type of the cement and the type of the aggregates and the sizes of the aggregates and the type pumping conditions and the density of the minimum cement content, size of the grids. Here, these are the test results, nothing but test data for the materials which has to be used for the mixed design. Here we have taken as a M40 grade concrete, right? For M20 grade of concrete, these are the cement materials are used. And these cement or any materials are before tested because of the properties with varying compressive strength are different. For the mixed design, these are the essential. So first test result for the material, cement used is 43 grade. That is confirming. Next, specific gravity of the cement. In the previous test, this result was not given. So specific gravity of the cement is 3.15. Next, chemical admixture, super plasticizer, confirming IS 19103. So what do you mean by super plasticizer? For chemical admixture, there are two types of the categories. One is a accelerators and one is a retarders. Accelerators accelerates the reaction. Retarders the reaction. Nothing but reaction time increases, reaction time decreases. These are two are depending on the site conditions. If it is a RMC, there should be a lag in the setting of time. If you are needing a urgent placing of concrete, in such cases there should be a separate specifications for usage of chemical admixtures. Next, specific gravity of the coarse aggregate is 2.74 and fine aggregate is 2.74. Coarse aggregate is also 2.74 and fine aggregate is also 2.74. Next, water absorption. Water absorption is 0.5% for coarse aggregate, 1% for fine aggregate. Obviously, for coarse aggregate, lesser water absorption. For fine aggregate, higher the water absorption percent. This one is the half of the fine aggregate. These are the data already given. In the examination also, they should give these datas. So, next, free surface moisture. Coarse aggregate, here they have taken a nil. Observed moisture also nil. Fine aggregates also nil. Next, sieve analysis. For sieve analysis, coarse aggregate, sieve size 10T, 10, 4.7 and 2.36. Analysis of the coarse aggregates fraction 1, 2, and the percentage of different fraction 1, 2 and combined. So these are taken from the conferring table number 2, IS-383. Only in the examination they permits IS-10262. So these code values are not so much important compared to 10262. Or they may permit IS-456-2000 and IS-106-2000. So from here onwards we are designing the mixed proportion. So first step, what is our first step? Target strength for a mixed proportioning. Here the formula is F dash CK is equals to FCK plus 1.65 into S. So F dash CK, target average compressive strength for 28 days. Target average compressive strength for 28 days. So this will be F dash CK. FCK, characteristic compressive strength. So this is already given 40. And the standard deviation value is S. So for F dash CK is equal to 40. Nothing but FCK value plus 1.65. into S. Now I will go with the table number 1. What do you mean by S and what is the value of S? That is page number 2, table number 1. For M40, S value is 5. Table number 1, page number 2. Again I will return into the mixed design procedure. In this mixed design you keep in mind, for every tables you should refer the code as per the regulations, then you short the design. So 40 plus 1.65 into S, your target compressive strength will be 48.25 newton per mm square. This is our F dash CK, target compressive strength. Next, so first step is over. Second step, selection of water cement ratio. Now what do you mean by WC ratio? We don't know the water cement ratio right now, but for in the problem itself they have given the water cement ratio is 0.45. so in the problem itself it is given W by C is equals to 0.45. so I will take the retain the same value, W by C is equals to 0.45. based on the table number 5, IS-456, keep in mind IS-456, not 10262, the maximum water cement ratio is 0.45. so based on the experience adopt the point ratio, W by C is equals to 0.40. so I am reducing the water cement ratio. In the problem they have given 0.45, but I am adopting 0.40. the reason behind this is taking a table number 5, IS-456, maximum water cement ratio. Next, so 0.4 is less than 0.45, hence okay, because we have taken a lesser than the given water cement ratio. Next is third step. So in the first step we have fixed up the target compressive strength, that is F dash CK 48.2 newton per mm square. Next, W by C is equals to 0.40. now I am concentrating on selection of water content. So for the selection of water content, again I need to go for a table number 2. So in this table number 2, maximum water content is given only for three types of aggregates, that is 10 mm, 20 mm, 40 mm. But in our present problem they have given 20 mm. So nominal maximum size of aggregate is 20 mm, hence the water content should be 186 liters, right? So here I will take water content is equals to 186 liters. But in this problem particularly they have given a slump range of 100 mm. See here, in the problem they have given a slump range of 100 mm.
for every 50 mm increase 3% of water content. So again I'm returning to the problem, 50 mm 3%, 50 mm 3%, totally for 100 mm 6% increase in the water content. So that's why the 186 liter given, it has been changed to 186 into 6%, or you can write 186 plus 6 by 100 into 186, that will be your 197 liter. So 186 will be treated as 197 because the transformation of 186 to 197 liters in the water quantity. But again there is a slight correction of the water. Initially I have taken 186, then I have corrected it to 187. In the problem they have used a super plasticizer. So by the using of super plasticizer, the water content can be reduced up to 20% based on the trial mixes. Here we have taken as a 29% reduction in water. Keep in mind, suppose in the examination if they don't given the slump value of 100 mm, then the water content will be 186 liters only. Need not to suppose increase the water content value. If they have given the slump value, then we need to correct the water content. Here they have not given the slump range, so 186 will be converted to 197 liters. Now again for 197 liters, usage of the super plasticizer, water content value will be reduces. How much reduces? By 29% it has been reduced. So you can write 197 into 29 divided by 100, calculate how much it will comes, and deduct from 197 minus 197 into 29 divided by 100, or we can take it as a 100 minus 29, 71%, right? So I am multiplying with 197 into 71 divided by 100 will be 140 liters. So initially I have taken as a 186, then changes to 197 liters, then it changes to 140 liters. So our final correction water content will be 140 liters. So third step is over. Water content is 140 and target compressive strength is 48. Now I am coming to the third step, calculation of the cement content. So I have taken formula W by C is equals to 0.40, right? I know the cement content value will be W by C is equals to 0.40. W is equals to C into 0.40. So cement content will be, cement is equals to 140 divided by 0.40. W by C is equals to 0.40. I am sending C here, so water content is 140 whole divided by 0.40 is equals to cement, that is 350 kg per meter cube. As per the table number 5 IS 456, for sewer conditions the maximum minimum quantity of the cement should be 320 kg per meter cube. Here I have taken a 350, so 350 is greater than 320, hence okay. Next, proportion of volume. This one is the most important volume. There is a small tricky here. So here volume of the coarse aggregate corresponding to 20 mm size of aggregates for zone 1, water cement ratio W by C is equals to 0.5, equals to 0.6, nothing but where there is a variation in the 10% of water cement ratio, W by C is equals to 0.5, 0.6. Whenever I have taken a W by C ratio 0.5, if I add a 0.10, nothing but 0.60, here it will be changes to 0.62. How? For every 5% increase in water cement ratio, there will be decrease in ratio of 0.60. So for every increase in 0.5, there will be increase in 0.62. So for totally 0.5 is equals to 0.60, 0.55 is equals to 0.61, 0.50 is equals to 0.60, 0.45 is equals to 0.61, 0.40 is equals to 0.62. So my final value is, for water cement ratio of 0.40, this value will be around 0.62. For calculation of the aggregates, pumpable concrete, that should be reduced to 10%. Again, from the 0.62 value, 0.62 into 90%, or you can take a 90/100. So the 0.62 has been reduced to 0.56. Initially I have taken as a 0.62. Now it has been converted into a 0.56. So the volume of the coarse aggregate is 0.56. So coarse aggregate plus fine aggregate is equal to 100%. Here I have taken as a coarse aggregate will be 56%. So the remaining 44% will be fine aggregate, because it's totally around 100%. So the volume of the fine aggregate will be 44% and coarse aggregate is 56%. The mixed proportion volume of the concrete, this one is the final step. Volume of the concrete is 1 m³. Volume of the cement is nothing but, so density is equal to mass by volume. So mass will be 350 divided by specific gravity of the cement is 3.15 into 1/1000. So the volume of the cement is be 0.110. So I will treat this one as an A or B. Okay, B. So the total volume of will be treated as an A. The volume of the cement will be treated as an B. Next, volume of water. Volume of the water is W by C from this result. So water content is 140 liter. So this will be C is equals to 0.140. Again, volume of a chemical admixture, that is 2% of the water quantity, that is nothing but mass of chemical admixture, 7/1.145 × 1/1000. So totally it is 0.006 m³. That you can call it as an D. D is equals to 0.006 m³. Next, volume in aggregates. So the total volume in the remaining will be aggregate. Cement is over, water is over. So the remaining volume will be volume of aggregates. A will be the total volume. So A minus B will be taken as an volume of the cement. Next, C will be taken as an volume of the water. D will be taken as an admixture. So the remaining volume is 0.743. This 0.743 includes coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. By adding the coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, the both value will be around 0.743 m³. Hence, the mass of the coarse aggregate will be volume of the coarse aggregate into specific gravity of the coarse aggregate into 1000. So 0.743 into 0.56 into 2.74 into 1000. Total value is 1140. Next, mass of the fine aggregate will be similarly. Here, there is a slight change. Mass of the fine aggregate will be 0.743 into 0.44. In the previous, I have taken a 0.6. Here, I have taken a 0.44 into 2.74 into 1000. So, the total volume of the fine aggregate is 896. Volume of the coarse aggregate is 1140. Hence, this is our final conclusion. Cement I have taken as an 350 kg per meter cube, water 140 kg per meter cube, fine aggregate is 896, coarse aggregate is 1140, chemical admixture 7%, and the water cement is 0.4%. This is the small illustration of M40 mixed grade of concrete. Next, I will give you the assignment. We can refer the IS-10262. Here, they have taken the illustrative example with the fly ash, partial replacement of an OPC. So, there is a small change here. Just I will tell the change, what is change. So, remaining steps is same. Calculation of cement is 320 kg per meter cube. Later this, the water content will be 140. So, by usage of the fly ash, 30% of the total cementitious material. Totally, we have got a cementitious material of 385. Only for this 30% will be 115. So for OPC 270, the remaining will be treated as a fly ash. So the total cementitious material will be fly ash plus cement. While saving the total cement of the using the fly ash, it will be 80 kg per meter cube. This is the slight change in the design, and the rest thing is same. We can go through the notes as well as the